Fresh off qualifying for next week's Democratic presidential debate, Andrew Yang is on a bus tour across Iowa, and Yang says he sympathizes with Iowans who are just absolutely getting inundated with political ads. He tweeted this, "I've seen half a dozen political ads on TV the past 15 minutes. I'm sorry, Iowa." Let's go live to Iowa, and presidential candidate Andrew Yang is joining us now. Mr. Yang, good to see you. You acknowledge Iowans have been buried in political ads. How do you break through?
Well, we break through by coming face to face and meeting Iowans where they are. I'm here in Iowa City, where we were greeted by hundreds of people who realize we have to rewrite the rules of the 21st century economy to work for us. And you're right, I don't think TV is the best way. You have to be here in person.
Congrats on qualifying for the next debate, by the way. You will now be the only candidate of color on that debate stage, despite a field that started out as very diverse. Why do you think that is?
Well, it's a hard job the DNC has. The fact is Kamala had qualified for next week's debate and would be there on stage if she hadn't decided to drop out. So we have to do everything we can to make sure that every perspective is represented on that stage next week. I'm certainly very proud to be the first Asian American man to be running for president as a Democrat and the only candidate of color next week.
On this issue of diversity, you've said that you believe your race has played a role in how your campaign has been covered. Explain how you see it that way.
Well, I think that our campaign was new to many, many people for a number of reasons. And I think the media is only just now catching on that I'm on the debate stage in December. We've outperformed over half a dozen sitting senators and governors and congresspeople because we're focused on the real problems that Americans see around us every day. And we're proposing real solutions that Americans are getting excited about. We're going to grow and grow and peak at the right time when voting starts in February.
But why do you think your race has impacted the way your campaign has been covered?
I'm sorry, Anna, I'm having trouble hearing you. Can you repeat that question again?
Yeah, I read in a couple of articles this week. Why do you think your race as an Asian American man has had something to do with how your campaign has been covered?
Well, I think Asian Americans are somewhat new to national politics at this level. I think that was one of the reasons why media organizations were just figuring out how to cover me in the campaign. Certainly, again, I'm very proud to be the first Asian American man to run for president as a Democrat. And I think that Asian Americans need to become more politically involved. A lower percentage of Asian Americans vote than other groups, and I would love to help change that.
You spent some time talking faith on the campaign trail there in Iowa, and you call your own faith journey an ongoing process. But you believe there's a way to crack into the traditionally Republican voting bloc of evangelical voters?
Yes, I do. I talk to evangelical Christians around the country who are deeply concerned about the values that President Trump represents. And they're concerned that their religion is being politicized, that people feel like for whatever reason, one party has something of a monopoly on the Christian vote. And that's not the desire of the people I meet around the country. Many communities of faith embrace our vision of a trickle-up economy that values every single person. I had the privilege of sitting with Martin Luther King's son after the last debate in Atlanta, and he said that this was his vision that Martin Luther King was fighting for when he was assassinated in 1968. Many communities of faith believe we have to help the least among us, and I believe that this campaign is activating more and more of those voters.
How do you see the issue of abortion playing a role in that?
Well, I champion women's reproductive rights as fundamental human rights, but I actually was reached out to by someone who is pro-life and said that my policy of a universal basic income for all Americans was the most pro-life policy she had ever seen, because she said so many families struggle with the decision to bring a child into the world based upon economic deprivation, and that if we could put more money into people's hands, then more families would be excited about bringing a child into this world.
You've talked a lot on the campaign trail and in interviews about your universal basic income policy, your primary policy platform, the Freedom Dividend. Beyond that, what else have voters there been asking you about?
Well, many voters are deeply concerned about the fact that our government is 25 years behind on technology and doesn't understand the fundamental transformation of our economy that the fourth industrial revolution presents. They're also concerned that our government is not up to the challenge of matching China in things like artificial intelligence. I'm one of the only candidates that sees the real challenges of the 21st century and understands technology's impact. And many voters here in Iowa and around the country are excited about a new way forward that includes trying to address technology's impact on our day-to-day life.
You know, one thing I learned about you this week is that you considered yourself a goth in high school, a claim Hasan Minhaj quizzed you on this week on his Netflix show. Let's listen.
Andrew. Ben Shapiro. Ben's. One eye, both eyes, and at least three piercings. All of the above.
Definitely all of the above.
That's right. You gotta cover everything if you choose that.
It's kind of hard to understand him because of the goth there, but I mean, there's a lot more to that episode. I watched it. You only got one question right. What kind of a goth were you?
Oh, well, you know, I was a goth who didn't get tattoos and didn't know three brands of eyeliner. But I was a very angsty teenager. I loved the Smiths and the Cure. And I think my fashion choices confirmed that I had no intention of ever running for president.
I got to get your take also on a new Thanos ad that the Trump campaign put out. It depicts him as the all-powerful Thanos from Avengers. Watch this.
I am inevitable.
Inevitable. What was your reaction to that?
Well, to me, I think it's clear who the pro-civilization good guys are. You know, as a big science fiction and comic book fan myself, you know, I think that the Democratic Party represents a constellation of patriots who want to do what's right for the country.
Andrew Yang, live in Iowa, thank you for joining us.
Thank you, Anna. Iowa, the energy's getting higher and higher. We love you for it, Anna. I will see you very soon.
And a final reminder.
Put the money in our hands. Can we afford it?
Yes.
Will it cause inflation?
No.
Is it awesome?
Yes.
Is anyone trying to make it happen?
Yeah, that guy.